Morning everyone, I am your science teacher Safiya. Today I am going to explain you a new topic, that is animal fiber. First of all, what is animal fiber? So in nature, actually two kinds of fibers are present. Those are natural fibers and artificial fibers. Natural fibers and artificial fibers. Natural fibers are obtained from the nature. That means they can be obtained either from the plants or either from the animals. So the fibers which are obtained from the nature, that is either from the plants or animals, are called as natural fibers. And the second one is artificial fibers. Artificial fibers can be obtained from the chemicals or by the combining of some chemicals with the natural fibers. We are going to learn about the natural fiber. As I said, natural fibers can be obtained from the plants or can be obtained from the animals. Regarding the plant, the fibers obtained from the plants, you have learned in the 6th class. You have learned about cotton and as well as the jute. Now we are going to learn. In this chapter, you are going to learn about two animal fibers. First animal fiber is silk. Silk is obtained from the worm, that is called as silk worm. And the second animal fiber is wool. Wool is obtained from the sheep, camel, etc. And how when do we use this wool? For making woolen clothes like sweaters, mufflers, gloves, etc. So as you can see, I have drawn a life cycle of silk worm. So which fiber can be obtained from the silk worm? Animal fiber, that is silk. So there is a cycle which will be continuous, and because of this cycle only we are able to get the fiber, silk fiber. So let us learn how this silk fiber can be obtained. Actually, here it is. You see that this silk we get from the silk worm. Okay, we are getting silk from the silk worm. And here usually, if you see a worm, that is what, caterpillar. You see the caterpillar of butterfly. Do you think it is useful? No, it is not useful for us. Okay, in the same way here, we are going to get the useful things from the caterpillar of silk. Okay, from the caterpillar of silk moth. So here, all the worms are not dangerous. Some are useful also. Like one of the useful caterpillar is silk worm. Okay, so the study obtaining of silk fiber, obtaining of silk fiber from the silk moth is called as sericulture. Don't get confused, students. You know, agriculture. What is agriculture? Growing crops for getting growing plants or crops to get food items is called as agriculture. It can be food items or any other thing which are grown. Okay, that is what agriculture. In the same way, here we have sericulture. Sericulture, in the sense, this silk, you can see a butterfly-like structure. This structure is actually called as silk moth. It is a silk moth. From this silk moth, we get the eggs. So the grower obtaining silk from the silk moth is called the study of, or the process of obtaining silk from the silk worm is called as sericulture. The process of obtaining silk from the silk worm is called as sericulture. So I can say that we are going to learn the topic sericulture. So first, how the sericulture starts. It will start from here. See, this is the adult moth. Okay, it looks like butterfly. If you see here, it looks like butterfly. So near the butterfly, you can find there are some dot-like structures. These are eggs. So our life cycle starts from here, eggs. Okay, from here we come to the end. First, eggs. Eggs are present here. So the eggs of silk moth are called as seeds. These eggs are also called as seeds. Why seeds, students? Seeds are used for growing new plant. In the same way, these eggs are used for growing new silkworm. That's why they are named as seeds. Eggs of silk moth are called as seeds. So So you can find, you can sericulture is usually, it will take place more in Pochampalli district. Pochampalli is famous for sericulture. Pochampalli is famous for sericulture. That means the complete process of sericulture will take place in the Pochampalli. Not only in Pochampalli, some other districts are also present here. So Pochampalli is called as Silk City of Telangana because the more sericulture will take place, many people are they are depending on the sericulture. So I'm taking here Pochampalli. Okay, Pochampalli is called as Silk City of Telangana. Moths, you can see the structure of silk moth. These are like butterflies. Okay, do you think we can keep it on the bench? No, if you keep it open, what will happen? Will they sit like you people? No, they will fly. So these silk moth are kept in the grill mesh boxes. A box will be like your mama will be keeping jewelry and all those. In the same way, they have a box which will be having grill on it. Grill, you know, for gates and all, you'll be having grill. Okay, so grill mesh boxes. So grill will be it will be have covering will be of mosquito net, like mosquito net covering will be which. Okay, like this coming box will be. This is the lid of it. This will be the covering. Inside this, the box is present. Okay, in the box we are going to put this all silk moths. Here are the silk moth present in the box, and this is the lid of it, which is grill mesh box. Okay, it has a chain, this structure grill, and it is having a net on it. Why net? That is because silk moth also need air and sunlight for their growth. Now silk moths are kept in the grill mesh boxes, and after some days, what will happen? Silk moth will lay eggs. Now the name of the silk moth which we use for rearing, that means for growing silk moth, is Bombax mori. So this is scientific name of this moth, that is Bombax mori. So at the time of laying eggs, these silk moths are removed from the grill mesh boxes and they are arranged on the white cloth or a big white paper bed sheets. So this mesh, this moths are kept on that at the time of laying eggs. And at the, later on, these moths can lay, they will lay eggs on that white bed sheets. Why we are using white bed sheet? It is because seeds are very small. That means eggs of silk moth are very small, and they are, we can't see if we are keeping it in a, on any colored bed sheet or if they are kept open. So to be, so our process may go wrong. So to avoid all those problems, they are using the white colored cloth or white colored paper. On that, these moths are kept. Moths will lay the eggs, and a female moth can lay 500 eggs in a go. 500 eggs. In a turn, okay, once only it can lay 500 eggs. After laying 500 eggs, moth will die. Okay, so the moths, which female moths usually they lay 500 eggs. After laying eggs, they will die, and other eggs, other silk moths will be surviving. Now we got the eggs. So sericulture, these are the basic of sericulture. Many people, they like to buy silk moth. If not, they like to buy eggs, or if not, they may like to buy the swarms also. To start sericulture, the people may like, they want to buy, they may buy the silk moth, or they may buy the eggs, or they may buy the small worms. It is completely depending on them. So these, the place where these things are sold, that is silk moth, eggs and worms, that is called as egg selling center. Egg selling centers are called as greenages. Are where this silk moth, eggs and worms are sold, that place is, that places are called as greenages. We have a famous greenage center in Chittoor district, Horsley Hills, Chittoor district. Okay, it is a big seed laying, seed selling center, or the greenages. Then moving on to these, eggs are kept on the special leaves, or the leaves are mulberry leaves. These eggs are kept on mulberry leaves. The eggs are allowed to hatch on mulberry leaves. Like so as soon as the egg hatches, a small worm comes out of it. Where these are kept, where these worms, where these eggs are kept, where worm will be present? On the bed of chopped mulberry leaves, or on the mulberry leaves. And as soon as it comes out of the egg, it will start eating. Who will start eating? Worm will start eating. And as it is going on eating, it will grow in size. And at this place, you can see here, it is little bit grown up. This worm, then it will eat little more and it will grow. Now we are at this stage. I'm talking about this stage. Where these worms are present? These are larvae. Where these worms are present? These are present on the mulberry leaves. So, like we eat, we can't eat grass. Do we eat grass? No. We eat certain type of fruits and vegetables. That is our habit. In the same way, are our food, I can say. In the same way, the food of these silk moth or silkworm is mulberry leaves. The food of silkworm is mulberry leaves. Wombat mori will eat mulberry leaves. And this larvae will be going on eating the leaves. This larvae will eat for 30 to 35 days. This larvae will eat leaves for 30 to 35 days. Continuously, morning and night, this larvae will be going on eating the leaves. This larvae, it will eat the leaves continuously day and night. Okay, and the place where it can be present should be hygienic. Okay, hygienic means the place should be clean. That means the leaves should be clean. They should not be rotten or they should not be dried up. So the hygienic conditions. Then they need sunlight, proper sunlight. And after 30 to 35 days, these larvae will stop eating. After eating 30 to 35 days, it will grow up to this much. Then now, this it has grown after 35 days. It has grown to this stage. This stage is nothing but caterpillar. At this time, what happens? This larvae will stop eating. Caterpillar will stop eating. It ate for 30 to 35 days. Now it will stop eating. And what it will do? It will start moving its head side to side like this. Side to side. While moving, it will be leaving out some saliva. Saliva, you know, you have liquid in your mouth. So same liquid is present in the mouth of this silkworm. This is worm. This is moth. Completely grown one is called as moth. This is called as worm. Okay, so worm will be having saliva. So it will leave the saliva. As it is moving its head side to side, what will happen? That saliva will be coming out of its mouth. And as a result, a net will be weaved. You can see this is moving. Okay, this larvae caterpillar is moving its mouth. So what happens here? It is moving side to side. Like this, if it is moving side to side, a net or the covering will be weaved. A net or outer covering will be made. Now, where is the caterpillar? It is in this. It is in this pupa. Okay, it is present here. So, this caterpillar will completely cover its body with its saliva. And this saliva, as it comes in contact with the air and light, as it comes in contact with the air, this will become hard. It will become hard. And this stage is called as pupal stage, or it is called as cocoon. Larvae will weave cocoon along its body. Okay, this cocoon will be made up of saliva. And this saliva, when it comes in contact with air, it will become hard. Okay, now this you understood. From eggs will get worm. Worm will be eating the mulberry leaves. It will change into caterpillar. And after 30 to 35 days, this caterpillar will stop eating. And it will start moving its head side to side. So as a result, a cocoon will be weaved around its body. This cocoon, this stage is called as pupal stage or pupa. After formation of cocoon, that is after at the pupal stage, these silk moths will grow inside. Already they have eaten, now they will grow in size. After 2 to 4 weeks, this silk worm will grow completely. Okay, it will change into moth within 2 to 4 weeks. After formation of cocoons, within 2 to 4 weeks, this caterpillar will change into silk moth. If it is changing into silk moth, what it will do? It will hatch this, okay, and it will fly away. And do you think if it will fly away, we get the fiber? No, we won't get the fiber. Then what we have to do? We should get the fiber. We will get the fiber at this stage only. These cocoons are stifled. These cocoons are stifled. So stifled or stifling. Stifling is a process to kill the larvae inside the cocoon. Stifling is a process to kill larvae inside the cocoon. Stifling is done at which stage? At this pupa stage. Stifling is done for the cocoons. How this stifling is done? Let me see. They'll collect all the cocoons. Okay, so here larvae they have got this cocoon, right? So what these will do? They will separate the caterpillar and the caterpillar which has weaved the cocoon. So now these are two different. So what they will do? They'll separate these two. These they'll keep in big cans for store, bringing milk from one village to other village. They'll use cans. In the same way, they will also use the cans or jars. Cans or jars. So these cocoons are present in these cans or jars. As within 1 or 2 weeks, these cocoons are collected again from the cans, and all the cocoons are weaved. They are heated. What they have, what is done here? All these are kept in one oven, okay, steam oven, and for 10 to 15 minutes that steam is passed. That means hot air is passed through these cocoons for 10 to 15 minutes. As a result, what happens? The larvae present inside the cocoon will die. The process is called as swiftening. Killing of larvae inside the cocoon by passing hot air for 10 to 15 minutes is called as swiftening. Now, larvae has been died. Now, it will not change into silk moth. Okay. So, as I said, at this stage, we get the silk fiber. So, these silk moth, again, here, people like to buy larvae or the grown caterpillar or the cocoon. It completely depends on the people. Like here, they can buy silk moth eggs or the small worms at the greenages. In the same way, these cocoon, caterpillar or small larvae can be buy at reeling centers where this swiftening and all other processes are done. That is called as reeling center. So these three things are stored or grown in the reeling centers. So if you want to buy the cocoon, then you have to go for cocoon markets. The people who do this sericulture, they will bring the cocoons to the cocoon market. They will seal all the bags with the they will be putting these cocoons, they'll seal the bags. They'll bring that sealed cocoon bags to the cocoon market. Cocoon markets are present in Nandikottapur, Hindupur, etc. There you can buy cocoons. Based on the rate, you have to buy the cocoons. It is your wish, you can buy cocoons. If not, you can buy caterpillar. And at the reeling centers, all they won't give, because we have to make fiber. So some cocoons will be present here. So we killed the larvae, now we should get the fiber. So from where do we get the fiber? This outer covering which is made up of what? Saliva of silkworm is nothing but the silk fiber. The saliva of silkworm is nothing but the silk fiber. What they will do? How we can get this silk fiber? So now cocoons are taken. Larvae is present inside, it is killed. Okay, there is a dead body of the larvae, I can say. Now these cocoons are boiled in the big containers, okay, are the big jars. All the cocoons are kept in the water and hot, it will become, they will be boiling those cocoons. So as they boil the cocoon, these cocoon will unreel. Unreel means it will get completely opened. Okay, all the reel will get opened. And they will get the ends of this. One end will be here, one end will be any other side. Why here? This, why they are boiling directly, they can take it, right? If they take directly, the cocoon may break. Okay, to understand this, I will give you example of groundnut. Groundnut, you know, nowadays we get groundnut like this. It will be present in the shell. In this groundnut shell, small groundnuts. So outer covering will be brown color, right? If you open it carefully, then only this cover will come easily. If you break as your wish, what will happen? This outer covering will also break. In the same way here, if you consider this the groundnuts or the seeds are larvae, which are not necessary for us, but the outer covering is important. So what we must do? We should be very careful when we are removing this outer covering. As I said, the outer covering is hard. To make it loose, we are boiling it in the hot water. As we boil in the hot water, this silk fiber will get separated. So here it is made up of saliva. Saliva contains two proteins. Saliva of silk moth contains two proteins. Cerisin and fibrin. acidic and the fibrin are the proteins present in the saliva of silkworm. So this silk fiber contains two proteins. What are that? Silicin and fibrin. So when we are removing this, slowly the ends of this will be located and they'll be removing that silk fiber carefully. And this is also done at reading centers. Obtaining the silk fiber by boiling the cocoon is called as reeling. After boiling, we'll get the ends of it. So after getting the ends, it will be colorless. So we need, you see, silk cloths are of different colors. So from where do they get the colors? The silk thread is colored. They will be cleaning first. Bleaching will be done. So if any color is present for that fiber, that should go away. It will become colorless. Now they'll be adding color. They may add blue color, pink, black, white, whatever color you want. They will be adding those color. After that, they'll be taking the threads and they'll be keeping on the reelers. You know, like this, it has home three machines will be. For that reels will come, colorful thread reels. How those will be a cover, what I can say, cardboard piece will be inside and outside completely thread will be. In the same way here, you'll get the silk fiber, silk thread. Cardboard will be taken and a big thread, big reel will be made with the help of reelers and twisters. With the help of reelers and twisters. Reels are made with the help of reelers and twisters. Is reeled with the help of reelers and twisters. Now here we got the reels. From these reels, the people will make the fiber. That is what they will weave the fabric. They will weave the fabric. Material, you say cloth, a piece of cloth is weaved with the help of these reels, colorful reels. They'll be taking these reels for the looms. Looms, you have came across the word looms in your 6th class as well, 8th lesson, fiber to fabric. So here two kinds of looms will be hand looms and power looms. So looms, they'll be taking this fiber to the looms and as a result, beautiful sarees, beautiful dresses, beautiful clothes will be made by using silk fiber. Okay. So here we got the silk fiber. But for example, I have 20 cocoons, I got silk fiber. But next time I have to do sericulture, right? Then how I should do sericulture if I kill all the cocoons, if I kill all the larvae here? It is impossible. So what they will do, some of the cocoons they will take for reeling and making fabric for the process. And some cocoons they will keep aside. So what happens, after some days they will keep it safely, they won't leave it open. After some days this cocoon will be changing into imago. Outer covering will be removed and it will change into imago. And this imago will be changing into adult, that is silk moth. Again the silk moths are kept in drill mesh boxes. They will get the eggs. Again from eggs, this cycle will be continuous. This is the life cycle of silkworm.